Okay, we're cleaning birds with Mr. Raul Andrade, and this is a quick tutorial. What do you call this phase right here? Desplumar.
This is the shagging part.
Shagging.
Or desplumar, whatever you want to call it.
Desplumar.
Pelándolas, you know.
Cuando estamos pelando la rancho de rey.
Las palomas.
Sí, las palomas.
So what if they're really easy to pluck? So the first is kind of friendly.
Sí, es lo que tiene que decir.
You know,
they're
really easy to pluck.
Necesitas hot water.
No, hombre, nada. That's right. A duck is a different story, but yeah.
You just turned the chicken face that.
Yeah. Pero pues sabes, la cosa es que you don't eat this every day.
Yeah.
Yo los meto en el freezer and I'll have some like every other week. Se acaba y ya sé. Porque después we continue hunting this morning though. Y luego after that, when it's there.
What do you call the next phase?
The next phase is you trim one of the wings like that. Get rid of it. We leave one wing on there for identification purposes. Then of course we take the feet off. Take a little bit of the tail off. Right there. Watch your fingers. And then we're gonna continue to get it this way.
Down the back?
Right down the spine.
Spine.
Okay. And then we'll take the crawl. Okay. Mira, right there. Okay. You marinate this baby. You split it in half. Right here. Put it on your grill. Oh boy.
Bacon.
Bacon? Yes, of course. A great botana. And then we start over.
Jalapeno rat.
Yeah, también. Look at the oil. You can do whatever floats your boat. Whatever pulls the trailer. Lo bueno que they're young birds. That's porque hay unos que they're older birds and they're tougher. But it's just young birds. They don't take a whole lot to cook. And they are tender and tasty. Real tasty. Remember we used to hunt for regreso. I was teaching school back then. I'd have my shotgun in my trunk and my shells and everything. I get out of school, I was teaching at South, and we all meet at Progreso, jump into one truck, cross the river, go hunt, you get a limit of one hour, like here. On the way back, we'd hire kids, bird boys, to do this. On the way back, we would stop at a place called Arispes. I don't know if it's still there. I haven't been there in a while. You come in there with your bag like that, depending on how many you're going to eat. There's usually a group of about 5-6 of us. Everybody bring their birds. Give them to the waiter, and he would ask you, how do you want them cooked? And wine and mushroom sauce. You take them in. He'd come back, he'd bring you a salad, then after that he'd bring you some beans, and he'd bring you several steaks.
Appetizers.
Yeah, appetizers. And at the end, they'd end on a big old charola, see, with all the birds. I think they used to fry them. You know, there's a Chinese and mushroom sauce. Oh, man, we're talking a feast. And everybody used to go there. Everybody used to go there. I know Ricky and all of us, we used to stop. Hey, at his best, yeah. Or there'd be another party of hunters. Okay, we'll meet at Arispes. No, but on the way back, we go across the bridge. They check our birds. That's it. How many do you have? We show them bags like that. Are they all clean? They're all, You couldn't bring them back with feet or is they guts or anything like that. I see. The guys are gonna look at them. Okay. It was a really fun deal. And there was a lot of birds, but then they start moving. They start migrating south. But we'd have about at least a good month of hunting on the other side of the river. You know? Of course, we had Mexican licenses. We had Mexican licenses where I remember the most I paid back when we were hunting Mexico was like $250. But let me tell you, it was worth it. You know, look at this. This baby has been shot last year. See that? Indentation there.
Oh, yeah.
You know?